I got a question. The developers agreement that Foxconn has, you mentioned that there was two of them. Okay, I guess my question is two parts. One, the development goals that you've got for contracting and for labor are set. Are those goals written into that developer's agreement, both of those? And number two, are there any contractual penalties for non-performance?
So, that's a two-part question. I will do my best to give you the response as I know it. So the answer is no. The Wisconsin First Commitments are not a part of the published development agreements. Our company, Gilbane M&W, our joint venture, together with our client, we have established economic inclusion goals to ensure that there is inclusion within Area 1, Phase 1. So it is a part of our agreement that we include in terms of the commitments within the agreements that we hold with the companies that are bidding to us and working with us. There is the expectation that your inclusion plan that is submitted with your bid will be executed based on what you have what has been presented to us, best and good faith efforts that you are executing the contracts that have been submitted as a part of that plan. We will require monthly reporting in terms of how the spend down happens with the companies that are a part of that plan, along with final payment agreements, which is a standard approach that we take across all of our projects. So an inclusion plan up front, demonstration through executed subcontracts, monthly utilization, and final payment at the end is our effort from a Gilbane M&W Group standpoint that we report back to our client.
And
Area 1, Phase 1.
And there's no penalty for non-performance?
There is no penalty for non-performance. We would expect that you would have the type of relationship with your partners that you're entering into agreements with, that you would be...
I'm not referring to my contractual obligations. Right. I'm talking about Foxconn's obligation to their development agreement.
So there is no visibility of these commitments in the development agreements with the state or with the village of Mount Pleasant. And those agreements are available online if you'd like to look at them.
They do spell out the penalties as far as the total number of job commitments and what is expected from the reporting structure. But the agreement doesn't go down into detail as far as reflecting these percentages. But this is where, you know, it's incumbent on us to consider if we're expecting Foxconn to commit to 13,000 jobs, if those 13,000 jobs are to Wisconsin residents, and how we make sure that we skill our workforce to be available to support Foxconn is what we're looking at. So it's just as much, you know, from them, it's a commitment because of the tax incentives and the credits, but from us, it's a commitment to, we got to figure out what those training programs are, we got to figure out what and how we pull in the workforce so that all 13,000 are here in Wisconsin.
Those are operational jobs post-construction. These commitments are representative of opportunities within Area 1, Phase 1 that Gilbane and the W Group will be administering as a part of our agreement with our client.
Okay. Our subcontractors required to bond back to Gilbane, or is it sort of non-bonded jobs?
I'm going to let Alan address that. Sure.
Performance and payment bond.
There we go. So why don't you give that question? Phil has a question.
Are subcontractors required to bond back to the